Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Master Distiller.
You know me, there's my buddy Mark Wayne Ramsey, Tim Smith. You're gonna make us some gin. If you win, you get a limited run of your gin for Sugarlands Distilling Company.
Obviously, you know something about gin or you wouldn't be here in this particular contest.
History's most notorious liquor, gin, is made by distilling a strong base spirit with juniper berries and other botanicals. Created by medieval monks as a plague cure, Dutch distillers perfected the spirit and soldiers braced for battle with it. Unlike whiskey or rum, gin can be made using any base spirit, from grapes to grains. Cheap, high-proof gin was churned out of back-alley pot stills in every slum in Georgian England, cut with turpentine and sulfuric acid. After the invention of the column still in 1831, purified gin hit the market, restoring its reputation and leading to the creation of the spirit's most iconic recipe, London Dry.
Lisa's already got her fire going.
Here we go.
There you go.
Me and Lisa's lit up. Y'all are still dumping liquor. Everybody's lit up and running.
On a London Dry gin, you don't want to go real heavy on the spices and the roots. You want more of a juniper-style flavor.
Getting the spice bill right is really key, because if you have too much of one spice or not enough of another, then you're going to have some off flavors. Let's see how it goes. Don't forget to write all your stuff down, guys.
It's all in memory.
It's all in your head?
Yeah. I'm really good at just, here's a pile of ingredients, make something.
Being a chef definitely helps with gin.
On these small stills, it doesn't take a lot. One or two will put you over the edge, and it goes from being pleasant to bitter in just a heartbeat.
Ooh, that's a little strong. Maybe too much.
Guys, y'all got 1 hour into your run, still got 3 hours remaining.
Well, it can make a difference on how they run it, though. Are they going to put it in the steel? Are they going to put it in the thumper? Are they going to infuse it later?
Yeah.
All right, that should be good. A few extra for love, a little bit of ginger for some spice.
Yeah, buddy.
I'm like talking to your still. It's like, come on, baby, just work for me. You guys talk to your stills at home?
Oh, yeah.
You talk to your still?
Nonstop.
Yeah, talk to your still at home?
Yeah, I call it a because it gets on my nerves every now and then.
You guys have names for your stills?
Money Pit.
Money Pit, that's a good one.
Mike's the only one out of the three that put his botanicals in the still pot.
Yeah, and the others, they put
everybody
it in
else put them in their thumper.
Yeah. With burners lit, heat vaporizes the alcohol in the base spirit. The vapor passes through the gin basket filled with botanicals hung in the cap or inside the thumper, where a second distillation takes place. Once the infused alcohol vapor hits the water-cooled coil, it condenses into a stream of London Dry gin.
Where'd you put your botanicals? In the thumper?
Yes. Yeah, I'm a big fan of vapor, in the thumper and the gin column.
I've done both ways, macerated and.
Yeah.
I think the vapor.
It just produces a nice light.
Yeah.
Flavor. It's nothing too extreme.
Right.
But
it's a lot cleaner.
A lot of your London Dries are vapor distilled too, Bombay or. I mean, I think Tanqueray is like the only one that's like. That I know of, that's macerated. I mean, I know there are
like
some other ones.
Old Tom styles usually are too.
Yeah,
but
maceration.
I mean, that's not a whole different ball game there.
Yeah, exactly. Glad we didn't have to do that.
That's what I like right there.
Woo! Oh, here we go. All right, we are flowing.
That is. Yeah. 180, 185 at least.
Time to start mixing?
Yeah, I'm messing around a little bit here.
I think I'm about ready. each part of the flow will produce a different flavor. You look at your flow like it's a tree. You know, at the very top, you've got the light, floral, airy parts, all the way down to the roots that come out in the botanical. So you have this full spectrum to capture all of that into a finished product.
Essential oils from the botanicals are released at different times during the run. Distillers must capture the drinkable alcohol in the heart of the run while balancing each flavor as it comes through.
Ooh, I smell that star anise.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Still fire?
No, it's good. It's like a, I think I'm getting like a little lemon.
There you go.
I wish I would have gotten a little more juniper out of it.
So you use a lot. It's like an excessive amount.
Yeah. I put a couple of slivers of lime peel in there.
Oh, cool.
Just a couple.
Very nice. Oh, here we go.
A legal distiller, a backwoods shiner, and a chef turned illegal liquor maker are competing to replicate the flavors of a classic London dry gin using only their palates as a guide.
Gentlemen, I got one good jar for you.
That's all it takes. Good luck.
All right, Dave.
Gentlemen, we'll give this a shot, see how she goes.
All right.
Okay.
That's one you decided on,
yes,
Lisa?
Yes, sir. Yes, it is. Thank you.
Alrighty.
Good luck, honey.
And this one here is Jason. It looks pretty clear.
Clear.
Good-looking jar.
110?
Might be a little better than 110.
The ingredients are super different. Like, you pop it into your mouth, it's one thing. You run some liquor through it.
Right.
And it's a whole different
flavor.
It
all changes when he gets it, right?
It's not too overpowering on a juniper.
The nose is a little bit stronger than the taste.
It is.
It's not unpleasant. I can tell the way it flashes across my tongue. It's warming.
It's got a little licorice.
And ginger. There's a lot of ginger in there.
With some tonic water and damn lime juice, that'd be a good drink.
Let's go to old Big Mike here.
Well, that's a little lower proof.
A 95? 90?
I'm going to go about 90.
I don't think I got enough flavor through mine.
And that's a total different taste profile.
But it ain't unpleasant.
No, but it's stout on the juniper side.
Them two both are, those are drinkable.
Wow.
What kind of beads she showing there, Timmy?
It's five, too. She's
nothing.
High.
That's low, showing low.
She's low.
That's low, yeah. Low.
80.
It's 100 proof liquor to start with.
I thought it was 200 proof.
Oh, it was 100. It was 100.
Yeah. It was 100 proof?
Yeah. How much did you cut it with water?
You put that water in it, it flashes, and it really can destroy
your
taste.
Her botanicals are in there, but there's not a lot of liquor in there.
Yeah.
You get that juniper up front, and then you got no liquor.
It falls flat.
Yeah.
Flat on its.
Yeah, she messed it up. Now comes the work.
Honestly, I like the smell of Mike's better.
Yeah.
But I like the taste of Jason's better.
Which one do you really think is more of a London dry gin?
That's tough.
Well, guys, I guess you all are wanting to see what our decision is at this point. This does not eliminate anybody. The winner of this round gets the pick of the litter. All the ingredients. Mike, your liquor was good. I get a lot of ginger with you. You get a little bit of that juniper, but it's a good drink. It would sell.
Lisa, you got a good product here.
Thank you.
It tastes good. It smells good. One thing I did notice is this. This is not 80 proof.
Okay.
Your fatal flaw was your blending. You went just a little bit heavy on the water.
Yes.
Jason, the nose is straight on gin. It's high enough proof, probably 110 to 115.
Oof.
But it still had a smooth taste. It's a good product.
Thank you.
Jason, you were the number one, Jock.
Thank you.